Fortifications have always formed integral parts of any defensive position. The Second World War would see advances in this area, in particular, the smaller defences surrounding strong points. In this video, we look at the Dragon's Teeth tank traps of World War II. Since the implementation of tanks during World War I, military defences needed to be strong enough to stop or at least deviate the movement of tanks on the battlefield. The first defences were usually made of timber, but were easily penetrated. A later example was the Dragon's Teeth tank trap. Called Dragon's Teeth for their obvious visual similarity to sharp teeth, they were implemented by not only German forces, but also the British and the French. They typically consisted of a square base with a triangular-shaped top made from reinforced concrete. Most of them were around 120 centimetres, or 4 feet in height, but could also vary in sizes. They would be positioned about the same distance apart in a row, which could be 3 or more deep. The general purpose of the Dragon's Teeth tank trap was to make it difficult for tanks to move through certain areas. If a tank were to drive up a trap, they would either become stuck and unable to move, or would likely expose the underbelly of the tank, which was not usually well armoured. Although made of concrete, the Dragon's Teeth were not indestructible. Engineers could lay charges on them to blow a hole in the defences, but this would be quite time-consuming and would leave those soldiers and the nearby tanks exposed as they waited for that area to be cleared. Further to that, in some areas, typically with German defences, the Dragon's Teeth would also be covered with landmines and barbed wire. Because of this, tanks were sometimes forced into specific areas of the defensive line, where gaps in the Dragon's Teeth were left open. These areas were usually heavily defended, or even covered by artillery, and set up as ambush points. During World War II, the French would employ Dragon's Teeth along the heavily fortified Maginot Line, along the French and German border. The British utilised the same defences, which were referred to as pimples, along their beach defences for the invasion, which ultimately never took place. The Germans utilised the Dragon's Teeth on a large scale, with thousands of them being installed along the Atlantic Wall. Perhaps more famously, the Dragon's Teeth were used along the Siegfried Line, which ran along Germany's western border. This area had thousands of them situated in huge lines which zigzagged along the countryside. Generally speaking, they were quite effective in slowing the Allied advances. However, ultimately, they weren't enough to stop the push into Germany. But a true test of these amazing defences is that thousands of them still remain even today, all across Europe. What did you think of the Dragon's Teeth tank trap? Let us know your thoughts in the comments section down below. As always, guys, thanks for watching. Be sure to hit that subscribe button if you want to expand your knowledge and join the growing Premier History community.